Hello, all of you beautiful butterflies. Today I'm going to be opening up the Jade Bratz doll, and I'm super excited. This is the third Bratz doll I'm actually opening up, so if you haven't seen my Shasha or Yasmin Bratz doll, please go check those out. But of course, we're opening up Jade, and I really like her cat icon or like thing that she has right there. I think it's one of my favorites. Well, Jade is one of my favorites of the Bratz dolls, so. Yes. Also, her packaging, the green color, I really like it. Also, I noticed that she has a bunch of different languages all on the back of her box and the front of her box, which the past two of my dolls did not have any different languages except for English on the back of their box and maybe Spanish. But these ones have French and a bunch of different languages. We can also see the cartoons on the back here, and I really like the drawings on the back. I think it really just adds a lot to the box, especially just since they draw them so well. Like, I don't know, I think they draw them really well. But since there was French on here, I thought I would read it in French since I've been learning a bit of French, not gonna lie. So this says, "Bonjour, je m'appelle Jade. Moi, passion pour la mode, ce sont les événements cool sound extremes et decals mas amis malpent cool cat pasqua je do la chats et uzi piku je sois cool." So hopefully I didn't butcher it too much. I will say that my accent is not there. I do not know how to do a French accent, but I am learning a lot of these words right now. So a lot of these words were familiar, shall I say. I forgot how to say familiar in French, not gonna lie. But she basically said, "Hi, my name is Jade. My fashion passion is clothes that are extreme and far out. My friends call me Cool Cat because I love cats and I am cool." Now, Cool Cat is with a K on both of them, so yeah. I also, like, everything here is in at least four or maybe in five different languages, which, I don't know, it's just so cool to me. But yeah, let's go ahead and get her open. I'm very excited to get her open and check out all of her outfits since she is one of my favorite dolls. So this does bring me back a bit. But yeah, let's go ahead and open up Jade. So if you haven't seen my other two unboxing with Shasha and Yasmin, you wouldn't have heard all of the complaining that I've already done about how hard it is to open up these boxes. Now on my third time, it was a bit easier since I now knew what you actually needed to cut and what you didn't need to cut, but for some reason, it was still very hard to get her out of the box. And this isn't even probably the worst part, getting her out of the box right here. It's the worst part for the camera because, as you can see, I can't fit any of it in the camera whenever I'm cutting the box open, but it is so that's probably the hardest part about this, is that it just won't stay in the camera view. You can barely see anything. So yeah, the actual worst part is opening, cutting all of those tiny little plastic ties that are on the back. Now there is this really cute poster. This came with all of them. It says "Girls with a Fashion for Passion." It has a drawing of all of the four girls, and then it says "Bratz" at the very top. It has a sort of galaxy background with it's like what is that word? Like where it's reflective type of thing, but it's like colorful reflective. I don't know what that word is, but yeah, very cute poster. It's the same poster for all of the dolls, but I still like it, so yes. Now all I have to do is take all of this extra tape off that's back here and then cut all of these ties that are everywhere. And this, like, all of the ties on the back are not the same for every single doll, so sometimes you'll have more ties on one doll and less ties on another. It just depends on how big the article of clothing is and how what's the other word that I was looking for? I guess that's it, how big the items of clothing are. So yeah, so there's so many little things that you have to cut, and honestly, I found out on this doll towards the end of opening it that it's just easier to cut all of the things off from the inside of the box and not the back of the box, because cutting them on the back side of the box, you have to work with like these huge scissors to try to go underneath this little tiny like thing. But on the front of the box, like it's just kind of there, like the string is there already, so you just cut the string. And I'm always scared cutting it open on that side because, you know, the clothes are right there or the doll's hair is right there or something, so I don't want to cut it. But I found out that it's literally so much easier. And you can see here that I found that out just now and started to cut off the one that was on the shoes, the one that was on the hairbrush, the one that was on the clothes, everything. I started doing it like towards the end. Very annoying for myself, but you know. I actually kind of really hope that y'all are enjoying these unboxing ones. I've been doing a lot of them, and I like doing review type things because I like buying things. So yeah, I like buying things, I like unboxing them, and so I've kind of been enjoying them. And there is a lot more, shall I say, unboxing thingies videos coming. So not only is there another Bratz doll that I'm going to open up, there's some more unboxing videos, and I'm kind of excited. I used to do a lot of hauls on Thursday videos, and now I'm doing a lot of unboxing during Thursday videos, so hopefully y'all still like a haul here and then, and hopefully y'all still like unboxing here and then. I feel like doing them like this, where it's like kind of, you know, there's sometimes there's an unboxing, sometimes there's this, is a good, you know, mix between them. So yeah, I hope that you're enjoying them either way. Anyways, going back to Jade and this Bratz doll here, I just had to cut off the backpack. The backpacks that come with these dolls, since they always come with at least one backpack or type of bag, they're always attached to the shirt or and pants, depending on how big the bag is. So yes. Now, I've already explained this like 45 million times, I feel like, how to open these things, but if you haven't seen my other two, basically, these things right here are super annoying on hair because it's always really hard to know if you're gonna cut hair, but you just sort of cut them where it's bended, and hopefully there isn't any hair in the part where it's bended, because if there is, it's just gonna be a whole hard thing to open. And yeah, like if you don't cut it, it's basically impossible to open it, in my opinion. It's difficult to open. She does have pigtails, which I'm kind of excited for. I usually don't put pigtails on my dolls, and they don't usually come with them in the packaging, so I'm excited to have pigtails on my dolls for once. So I decided to keep the hat on her. Most of the time I cut hats off of dolls once I get them out of the packaging, just because I don't always keep the hat on them, and if I want to ever put the hat back on, I can always just put it back on. But with her hat, I felt like it was going to be hard to keep on, so I just kept the ties that hold the hat on there, and I didn't cut them at all. She does have movement at the ankle whenever she has shoes on, knee, she also has movement at the hip, shoulder, and head, so she has a lot more movement than a regular Barbie, but still very limited, I could say. Still limited, not very limited, but still limited. Now, these pants are super cool. They're like a green, they have a red pink stripe down the middle of the pant leg, and they're super cool. I think it's supposed to be some type of like camo-y type color. I'm not really sure what the texture or design is supposed to be, but I like the color and the design. Now there's this sparkly skirt, which is super cute, and it has a band around the bottom that's fuzzy. And then this one, which has long sleeves that have circles on them. The cat on the front, the cool cat little icon with a regular pink shirt. And then there's this see-through red glittery shirt. Glittery? One of those. It's a glittery shirt that's a crop top. And then she has these super cute trainers or joggers, and they have like loose laces on them, which I already gone into Shasha about, because she has the same loose laces as Jade does, which is, no, don't ever have your laces that loose, girl. Tie your shoes better, double knot if you need to. And then she had these gray heels and then this pink belt. I think that Jade's is probably the closest to mine, but she also has this purple brush that has Bratz and a couple stars on it, but I think her style is the closest to mine. I really like her style, not gonna lie. Here is the outfit she comes in the box with on her. I'm going to try on all of the four outfits and see how they all look. This is the first outfit. I really like it. Probably my favorite. Maybe. This is the second one. I really like this one, actually. This okay, I don't want to say this one's my favorite, but I like this one. I like this one because I feel like it goes with the green better than the pink, just because the stripe on the side is red. As you can see, like, the stripe on the side's red, so I feel like it goes a little better. The hat, though, does not go with this outfit. It's just there because I don't want to take it off yet. Then we have this one, which I feel like if the skirt was red, or maybe if the shirt was a bit more pink, that it would have, like, matched better. But I feel like this one just doesn't match at all. Kind of missed the mark for me. I don't really like this outfit. It's cute, but I don't know if I'm going to display her in this outfit. But we do have one more, which is this shirt with the belt and the skirt. This is my favorite outfit. There we go. I can finally say it. This is my favorite. The first one is adorable. I really like it. I really like the pants and the shirt combo together. But this outfit right here, it's just there. It's amazing. I really like it. I would wear this outfit, is basically what I'm trying to say here. I would wear this outfit in a heartbeat. I loved that last outfit. But yeah, guys, that's all for me today. I really hope you enjoyed this video of me unboxing the Jade doll, the Jade Bratz doll. If you did, please leave a like. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe and hit the bell to get notified every single time that I post. You can also check my description to see my Instagram, and on my Instagram, I post like a couple of times. A month, maybe, I don't know. And then you can also comment down below anything that you want, really. Did I say to like? Did I say to subscribe? I feel like I did. Hopefully I did. Yeah, that's all. So, goodbye.